So I've made a handful of videos about what we call Lake Bravo. Lake Bravo is the big lake directly behind my house, which is 100 acres and 48 to 52 feet deep. We stocked it 2 years ago this month with bass, and in the 6 months prior to that, had stocked it with bluegill, shiners, minnows, all kinds of stuff. Where I live, we have a lot of Mayan cichlids, also known as atomic sunfish. These are related to your typical tilapia because they're all cichlids. And we thought that a lot of the fish that we were seeing in the shallows might have been the atomic sunfish, but it turns out that most of them are in fact bluegill. Tons and tons and tons of bluegill. That's what I was curious about seeing, is what the little panfish were. And most of these are not big bass. None of these bass that you see here are more than about a pound and a half, but you can see the quantity of the fish is amazing. Actually, just two random spots for the most part that I could actually get out to the edge of the deep water and just set the camera down. I'm kind of thinking that this is probably what I would find all around the lake, and in the next few days I'm going to try a few different spots and see if it has just as much fish in other areas of the lake. Fascinating that the bluegill live within feet of fish that can eat them, and you see everything is basically a calculated risk. You see them clear out when a bigger bass comes into the picture. Long-term goal is to try to raise the state record bass, and I plan on documenting that along the way, but it's going to be a several year journey. Here's another one where the bass, they actually just look like sharks almost coming into the feeding area, or the area where all the bluegill were. They just come in, you see them, you see the bluegill just take off, and then all of a sudden this, you know, a bigger bass, it's probably a pound and a half, 2 pound bass, something like that, I'm guessing, just comes cruising into the picture and everybody's scattered. So I think next time I'm going to try and figure out how to get some of the bigger bass on camera. Not real sure how to do that. Any really good suggestions for how to get some of the big bass on camera, let me know.